Namaskaram. Snanayatra is a yearly ceremony which takes place in Jagannath Puri and all the other temples of Lord Jagannath, where Lord Jagannatha, Baladeva, Subhadra Devi and Sudarshana are bathed once in a year on this Purnima, Snana Purnima. And it is also said that Lord Jagannath gets sick after this bath and he doesn't give darshan for few days, and he directly comes outside to give darshan to everybody on the streets on Jagannath Rath Yatra day. As we know, there are four yugas: Krita Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga and Kali Yuga. Right now we are in Kali Yuga, and Krita Yuga, the very first yuga, is also known as Satya Yuga. So during this Satya Yuga, there was a devotee king named Indradyumna Maharaja, and he had a constant wish to have darshan of Lord Vishnu. And this Indradyumna Maharaja, he comes under the family line of Malwa dynasty, and he had this constant desire to have darshan of Lord Vishnu. Once a Brahmana, he visited this Indradyumna Maharaja and told about a place called Neelachala, where the deity of Lord Neelamadava resides. So he also told that whoever takes darshan of this deity gets liberation at once. So this king became more inquisitive about this Lord Neelamadava, and he wanted to have his darshan. So he chose one best among the men called Vidyapati to go to this place called Neelachala and explore to get more information about this place. Now Vidyapati was very happy and excited to go there and have the Lord's darshan. So he walked and went, and he didn't feel any hunger or thirst because he was in the thoughts of Lord Vishnu. He was meditating on Lord Vishnu. And when he went there, he met a tribal person called Vishwavasu, and who was smelling divinely after he had the darshan of Neelamadava in Neelachal Dham. And he was so surprised, and he requested Vishwavasu to take him to get darshan of Lord Neelamadava. Vishwavasu asked him to come home and take some prasadam before leaving, but then Vidyapati was persistent that he would not eat anything until he has darshan of the Lord in Neelachal Dham. So Vishwavasu was first hesitant to take him, but then later, after multiple requests, Vidyapati was taken by Vishwavasu to have darshan of Neelamadava. So they had a night-long walk in dense forests, and they climbed over the mountain which is called Neelachal, which is literally called Blue Mountain. So there he had darshan of Lord Neelamadava, who was seated on Adisesha, and it was a beautiful sight, and he was very happy. And after coming back, Vishwavasu took him home to serve him prasadam. And again, Vidyapati was so surprised to see how many delicious offerings, so many sumptuous prasadam was there. And Vishwavasu told him that all the demigods, the devas, they come and offer such wonderful offerings to Lord Neelamadava, and that is the prasadam which he is eating now. Few days before Vidyapati left Neelachal Dham, he expressed Indradyumna Maharaja's desire to build a temple for Lord Neelamadava to Vishwavasu. On return, Vidyapati gave a fresh garland of Lord Neelamadava to King Indradyumna, and Indradyumna was very happy, and he was very eager to know more about Lord Neelamadava. And at that time, Narad Muni also came there, and Indradyumna Maharaja paid his respects and told about his desire to build a temple for Lord Neelamadava in Neelachal Dham. And he also requested Narad Muni to give more information about this place and about the Lord. And he was very moved when Vidyapati was describing the beautiful form of Lord Neelamadava seated on Adisesha as a throne with his eternal consort Sri Mahalakshmi Devi. On an auspicious day, Indradyumna Maharaja, Narad Muni and several others, they set out to Neelachal Dham to have darshan of Lord Sri Neelamadava. And when they went there, the Lord wasn't there. The Lord had disappeared, and only a heap of gold sand was there. So this shocked everybody else, and they heard a voice from the sky that the Lord would certainly give darshan to Indradyumna Maharaj, but in a different form. So Narad Muni gave instruction to Indradyumna Maharaja. He told him to perform 1,000 Ashwamedha fire sacrifices, and the king performed 1,000 sacrifices. And after that, it was revealed that the Lord would appear in ocean in a Daru Brahman form, which is a sacred log form. So after that, in the ocean, a log of sacred wood, Daru Brahman, appeared with the marks of Shankh and Chakra, conch and disc, appeared in the ocean. And now they had the big question of who would carve the deities of the Lord from this Daru Brahman. The best carpenters were engaged to carve the deities, but their tools kept breaking. They couldn't continue carving the deities. And then the king heard a voice stating an old carpenter would carve these deities, and he would take 21 days. And when he carves, nobody should open the door. And if somebody does, the carpenter would stop working and he would disappear. So this was the condition. An old carpenter came, and this was the condition he told the king. So everybody could hear the tick 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 sound of this old carpenter carving the deities. And when it was the 14th day, they couldn't hear this tick tick sound. So Queen Gundicha, wife of Indradyumna Maharaja, and Indradyumna Maharaja, they both were worried what if the carpenter had fallen sick. So they decided to open the door on the 14th day. Actually, the carpenter had told them not to open the door till 21 days. But then they were worried and they tried to open the door. But then the minister warned them not to open. But still, they were concerned and they opened the door. And as per the condition, the old carpenter, he disappeared. And the deities weren't carved fully. They were incomplete with no hands. The king regretted this badly, that he had opened the door and the deities were incomplete. But then Narad Muni assured him that this was the Lord's desire, that Lord Vishnu wanted to reveal themselves in the form of Lord Jagannath, Lord Baladeva, Sri Subhadra Devi and Sri Sudarshana. And as you know, Lord Jagannath is black in color. He is none other than Lord Sri Krishna. Lord Baladeva is white in color and he is none other than Sri Balarama himself, the elder brother of Lord Sri Krishna. And Sri Subhadra Devi is the sister of Lord Krishna and Balarama, and she is also the wife of Arjuna, the great devotee of Lord Sri Krishna. And there was also Sudarshana, the deity of Sri Sudarshana, the divine weapon of the Lord. And Narad Muni advised Indradyumna Maharaja to invite Lord Brahma to install the deities of Lord Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadrama and Sudarshana. And as those days in Satya Yuga, people could travel to other planets. So Indradyumna Maharaja, he went to Satyaloka to invite Lord Brahma to install. So Lord Brahma, he came to this Neelachal Dham, which is also known as Purushottama Kshetra, and he installed the deities in the Jyeshta month, May-June month, on a Purnima day, full moon day. So now Indradyumna Maharaja was very happy to have these beautiful deities. And even this day, if we visit Jagannath Puri, which is Purushottama Kshetra, which is in Odisha, we can have darshan of the beautiful forms of Lord Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra and Sudarshana. And it is also said that these forms, they appear very strange, right? We'll see this story in the next video probably. And their forms, in this form, they are considered to be very merciful, and they are, because in this form they are very happy and they are very, very merciful. Let's all pray to Lord Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra Maharani and Sudarshana to bless us devotion and love unto them. Now we have my students Uma, Shraddha and Shankar sing with me on the glories of Lord Jagannath.